오빤 강남 스타일. 강남 스타일. 오빤 강남 스타일. 강남 스타일.
Oh shit. That was hilarious. Well, we're chilling in Richmond, Virginia, while this superstorm is blowing in just north, I guess. Right?
Yeah.
Good times. Yeah, it was sleeting this morning here in Richmond. We left the truck stop. Great times. We managed to get a door today. We didn't have an appointment. For whatever reason, nobody made an appointment. I contacted them early yesterday and let them know that we'd be... Or you contacted them. I'll give credit where credit's due. Just like the good secretary, she managed to run her digits across the keyboard yesterday. And I think you found your calling. Going for like secretary interviews and shit, and they go, can you type 80 words per minute? And it's like, I can type 8 words a minute. Maybe. If I can break off from drinking soda and smoking my damn vapor pipe. Especially if it's like with some dude, like some CEO office, you know, fag or something like that, and he's like, I need somebody that can dictate. And you're all, uh-huh. And you're like, I go in for that interview and just say, how's about I just walk around in a thong, sir? Would that work? He's all, ugh. He just throws up on the floor. He's all, ugh. So, you have too much hair coming out of your ass crack, sir. Oh. And when you bend over, it looks like a goat wandered through the room. I like how you do that with your mouth shut. You go, yeah, it's good times. It's a little chilly out today.
A little bit.
Ah, it's only in the 30s or something. I thought we were done with this winter shit. I was really hopeful. Well, I should probably give us a load. Oh, we need you to go up to Maine. fuck. I'm gonna put a plow on the front of that truck. I don't know if it's really all that bad up there. I haven't seen the weather yet, but I should hit up Jermaine, a buddy of mine. He lives up in Boston. He posted something a little while ago about snow or something like that. I don't know. I don't know if it's real bad, but we're missing it down here, which is nice. If we'd had a load going to New Jersey or something, we would have got in there right before the storm, and we'd be sitting there right now. Good times.
Yeah.
Yeah, they closed down I-90. We've been getting messages from the Qualcomm, too. Closed down I-90, I-81, I-95, like every major freeway out there, I guess. So. Right?
Yeah.
What are you doing?
I'm trying to fix my phone.
Yeah, her phone died last night. Like, we went in to take showers. Literally just died all the way. Came back out, plugged it in, and maybe we'll get comments about that. Maybe somebody would know what to do with it.
Maybe.
Because it wouldn't hold a charge after that. It's a Note 5. I don't know.
She's
had it just about a year before the Note 7 came out, you know, and they're all blown up or whatever.
It'll only charge if it's turned off.
Oh, it's not charging at all right now?
No, only if I turn it off.
Yeah, and we got, like, the high-speed chargers and shit like that, and it's not holding the charge now. It's that ion lithium battery. And what'd you hear about it? Like, if you do let them go dead, they take a shit on you or something like
that? Yeah, but everything I'm reading now says that now it's like a firmware issue. So.
I got something firm for you. You're all gross. God. Husbands are gross. Get away from me. Typical marriage. God.
Stupid.
Going to the bar. Gonna drink Bud Light and watch football. So my wife has no affections for me.
Yeah.
Instead of eating chicken wings, I'm gonna come home and breathe that on the back of your neck in bed. It's fucking... Good times.
Yeah.
All right. Oh, yeah, so nobody made an appointment for this place yesterday, apparently. They said they were going to try to, and then just go ahead and go in there at 7 in the morning when they open and see if they'll take you. And I'm all right. But we're like 25 miles away, you know, at a truck stop. We staged in town, but it was up on the north side of Richmond at the TA up there. So turn around, come in here at 7 in the morning, check in, and they're all, you don't have an appointment? Well, no. Dispatch just told me to come in here. Like, who do you drive for? P to the rhyme, and they said, well, they should know better. They're a big company. They come here all the time. They know you can't come here without an appointment. I'm just looking at like another lost day, you know? It's like, oh, great. So, because we got into Richmond yesterday and, you know, waited till today, and then they're saying no. And then they managed to make an appointment for $1,300. So, okay, and they called us, they had my number already, and they called me, like, right at 1 o'clock, pretty much, and said, oh, put it in the door, whatever, and I'm, all right, so we're sitting here in this door, but we're not totally backed in, because we got to wait, and then they'll come out and tell us when to open the doors, because it's a load of ice cream, so it's frozen, they don't want the doors just sitting there open while nobody's unloading it, so, good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I love it. You're not even going to get this trip turned in for payroll, probably. We're going to have a totally negative week this week. Going to be in the hole for probably about, what, $1,500 on the truck.
$1,500
in
gas, probably. Fuel.
On fuel?
No, probably like...
On petroleum distillates?
No, how much fuel do we put in? Like $400,
$500? We filled up twice. And then I got 30 gallons yesterday just to... finish this up over here. I didn't want to fill it all the way up.
What's that, about $800?
I got 148 gallons on the first fill up, and then 140 on the second fill up, so you're looking at three, and then fuel price in Arizona was $2.13, and then fuel in Oklahoma City was $1.84, so... Got nice fuel prices, that's one thing you can't say. Working on a big system like this. Although, the place we're contemplating already right now too, the fuel discounts are even better. Because they have twice as many trucks, huge fleet. You know. And they work through all TAs and Petros. I remember I used to get like 30 cents off a gallon and stuff like that. Like crazy fuel prices. And I was like, hell yeah. I get my fuel surcharge put on my card. Because they would front you like 40%. Or the fuel surcharge, and they'd also front you 40% of the line haul. So you get your fuel surcharge put on the card and everything. That'd be sweet. I actually had money in the bank because I was getting like 8 miles to the gallon with my truck at the time. And most fuel surcharges are based on 6.5 miles a gallon. So I remember I had like a spare like $3,000-$4,000 sitting on my card all the time back then from my fuel surcharges. So it's pretty cool. Hopefully we get back to something like that.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Without exposing too much information. Throwing the bait out there. People are like, what are you doing? What's going on? Just
nothing.
Just putting my finger in the pond, you know, and stirring it around a little bit, making little waves, checking some stuff out. Nothing yet. Yeah, absolutely nothing yet. We gotta build up some money. So good stuff.
Yeah.
Alright, fuck, 10 minutes already. God damn, dude. We're so interesting.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so
Richmond, Virginia, waiting to get unloaded. Check back in a while, I guess.
Yeah.
Oi! Oh, I didn't get you on the bus.
Oh, don't hit him. Looks like we got a newbie out here. This is that thing I was talking about in the past, too, where you get guys outside of the truck, you know, giving directions. This guy's got his arms out there flailing like crazy. La, 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 la. Looks like he must have a new dude in his truck with him because he's wearing a safety vest, too. Usually you take that shit off. Well, you always notice that, like, Swift drivers, stuff like that, they're always wearing a safety vest. It's funny. They could be anywhere. They could be walking into Walmart and they got a safety vest on. I don't know why, but. And this guy's got a straight back shot now and he's still hesitating. So that tells me it's a newbie. Noob. Fucking noobs. Nah, but I wish you could see where this is. The dude's on the other side of the truck right now watching him. But he's got arms just flailing. La, 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 go this way, go that way. Ba, 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 ba. Where are you going, dude? Why are you turning? Oh, my God. I mean, he's already in the hole. You can fix that, you know, with minor adjustments. Hey, who am I? According to, you know, other people, I'm not a real truck driver, so... Right?
No, you're a real truck driver.
According to our critics on YouTubing. Where are you going, bro? Where are you going? No.
Maybe he was too far over?
You can still fix that. You put it back in the hole as far as you can without hitting anything, and then you do a little pull-up. You cannot... When you have that much limited room in front of you, you can't do too much correction. It's just a matter of... You put it back... in the hole as far as you can, tweaked or whatever, and then do a pull up and adjust, you know, do a full adjustment. See, this guy's just going back and forth, man. He's fucked up. He's out there getting frustrated, was it? You can see the truck jumping and stuff. He's out there popping the clutch. And I mean, I know how this is, you know. I've been there myself. I'm not downing on the guy. It was just,
right.
He's frustrated. And this other guy, this is where when you have somebody helping you, it can actually hurt you. Yeah, that you get into the thing when you're, especially a newer driver, you listen to the other guy 100% and you don't even think for yourself. Guaranteed, if you were to leave this dude alone, I did this to trainees before, I figure it out. I'll keep you from hitting shit, you know, if I say stop, stop, but figure it out. Because that's the only way you learn.
Yeah.
It's the only way you learn that little formula of how to back up a truck. You know, it's a whole backwards way of thinking. That's the only way you learn, though, is trial and error. The only thing I'd ever do is just, like, put up, you know, the stop, you know, fist mark. You know, stop, stop, stop. You know, that'd be about it. Just don't hit shit. I'll keep you from hitting it. But other than that, you're figuring it out on your own, dude. I'll avoid the incident. I don't want paperwork. But other than that, you gotta learn this shit on your own. So, good times.
Sure.
See, the dude's out here still just flailing his arm. Oh, go do the... Oh, he wasn't even with him. The guy just disappeared down the trucks. So that was the other thing I've talked about before, too, though. How that hurts you.
Yeah.
You got a guy out there that you do not know how to communicate with. You don't know what he's talking about. He could be saying, turn wheel to the right, when you think he's flailing to the left, you know? It's like, what? That's why when people have tried to help me before, they hop out and it's like, dude, I'm good. Don't worry about it. So there he goes. He's finally getting in. Let's go. Worry about your new phone later. Yeah, we had to go get her a new phone. Her Note 5 took a shit. Called T-Mobile, tried to get all worked out. No dice. Didn't work. Have we got a spot? Or is there a bobtail sitting in it? We got a spot. And pop the brakes. Because somebody else is parking the truck, right?
Yeah. Got the right tilt, too. There's a flatbed back there, so better get to it.
Alright, I'll go do it. Fuck. good. I'm good.
Well, here we are in, was this Stewart's Draft, Virginia.
Virginia.
Yeah, managed to get unloaded yesterday. Ran over here last night. It's a nice place. Actually, a nice little town.
Yeah. Nice area.
Out here in the, these still the Appalachian Mountains or whatever. Blue Ridge Mountains, Virginia. Something like that. Some fucking hillbilly shit. I don't fucking know, man.
No, it's a nice town.
Nice place. You can see the mountains up there. They actually got snow here from this storm out this way. Got into the Pilot truck stop over across the way, like, it's like 7 miles away where we came from, and
they had snow there too. Didn't get any snow over in Richmond, but well, it was sleeting the night before. But
you can see here, well, if the sun's not fucking killing it, we got the red light on the door right now. We just hooked up to this trailer and
waiting to get loaded. We're at the Hershey chocolate plant in Stewart's Draft, Vagina. It's kind of cool driving around though, driving in, see all these old colonial style houses and stuff. Everything's real old. I always like it.
I always like seeing that shit.
Yeah.
Right?
Right.
I don't know. Nothing much going on though. I'm taking this, going back to Utah. Heading out of here, taking the 64 across to the 70 over to Kansas City, take the 29 north up to the 2 in Nebraska, into Lincoln, Nebraska, where we catch the 80, and then cruise the 80 the rest of the way across over to Salt Lake. Yeah. At least it's a dropping hook. It's kind of nice.
Yeah.
Speed things up a little bit. Oh, and I did our last month. For anybody that's still curious about the rates we're getting and shit, had a lot of low rates and a few decent rates, I guess you could say. Overall, our average for the entire month, which I would say isn't bad for Prime. You know, I mean, when you do a lot of contract freight, like Prime has, Swift has, companies like this, they negotiate lower rates so they can get all that business. You know, it's kind of quantity over quality. But then as the drivers, they have to earn money off those rates, especially with a high truck payment, insurance, fuel, da 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 da, that, you know, sometimes the rates kind of hurt. But on the plus side, our average rate, like I was telling you on our last thing, we were averaging around $1.17. Rates have improved a little bit for us. We're averaging up around $1.35 now. That's with deadhead miles included, because those are still, when people do their rates, they don't include deadhead miles a lot of the time. That it's just your loaded miles. Well, you have to eat those deadhead miles too, so you want to include everything. You know, you still burn fuel. You don't get compensated for your empty miles. So, and then two, you got out of route miles. You know, when they do a dispatch too, the miles are from A to B. It's like crow flies miles, you know, straight line miles. So a lot of times too, it says it'll be like 1950 miles on a dispatch. Well, it ends up being like 2015 miles or something like that. So it's extra miles that you actually have to burn up that you're not getting compensated for. But that's just trucking. That's the way it's always been. So, but even with all the deadhead miles in there and stuff, so it actually, if you just did on your loaded miles, the rate would have actually been higher. But the reality is, you already ate all those extra miles and burned the fuel for them. So, you pretty much just got to put them in your mix. And then too, when you break down your fuel cost, a lot of times they only do it on fuel. That, you know, your fuel surcharge pays for fuel. Well, what about DEF? You know, and DEF is actually more expensive than fuel. And a lot of times you're putting in an extra 5 or 10 gallons of DEF at $2.79, $2.99 a gallon. And you don't get compensated for that. So,
again, it's just one of those little things in trucking that they, you know, over the years, they just whittle at and cut down. I mean, it's anybody. It's not just here. You know, it's not like we're getting ripped off or anything. It's just a thing of, it's one of those things, man. So, yeah, we're averaging $1.35, though. It looks like we may actually be out of the hole this week. We'll make up the negative, like, $550 or whatever it was. Last week for being home, we went in the hole over $500. We turned around with this one trip out here to Virginia, the load of ice cream from Nevada, that will actually come out maybe even a couple $100 on top. So, not too shabby. Right?
Night.
You slipping, catching you slipping. So next week we should be pulling down a paycheck again, which will be nice. Going home, man, costs a lot of money.
Yeah.
Well, especially because we did a lot, but I remember even when we just went home while we were with Transco before, like, you go through a lot of goddamn money, because everybody wants your time, you know, wants to go shopping, wants to do this, wants to do that. You got to take care of extra crap while you're home and everything. And you realize you go through a lot of goddamn money. So... bills are caught up though.
Sure.
Yeah, I went to the Pilot, you know, went in to go get a coffee this morning. Their coffee's already bad tasting enough. And then all of them were, all the coffee fucking crafts were blinking, which means they've been sitting there on the burner for hours. I was like, God damn it. And it was like 7 in the morning. They didn't even make new coffee, man. I was like, son of a bitch. Went over and told the broad, you know, because they're all just standing around as usual. I go, hey, all your coffees are blanking. But I bought this Starbucks fucking thing. I was like, God damn it. She's like, oh, they're all blanking? Oh, man, we got to make new coffee. Oh, I hope that one dude's working when we go back.
Oh, yeah.
I got a picture of this dude. Holy shit. He was working the other day before when we were there. And there's something about a Virginia accent. You know, there's southern accents, but you can tell where people are from, you know, and how soft or weird their accent is. But Virginia has one of those ones that just sounds kind of half gay and backwoods at the same time.
Yeah.
I don't know. I've always said West Virginia and Virginia, especially like Western Virginia. It's the shallow end of the gene pool kind of thing. You know, they just, but this guy, his hair was amazing. I would have gone up and kissed him on top of his head, on top of his bald head. Okay, he had like that little stringy comb over kind of shit, like just little strands of hair coming over from here to here, right? The guy's fugly as a pig, dude. But he had that stringy comb over hair. And then his hair, like he had the horseshoe deal going on, you know, where you go bald. And his hair here was all long. And it looked like he even used a straightener on it.
Yeah, it was really straight.
It was really straight. It went straight down and actually curled around his head. But it happened all the way around. And then it was like down this length. And it actually like curled around.
Like he should be taking professional photos with his cat. Yeah.
We were talking about it. You could find redneck pictures online of like a dude holding a shotgun and a fucking Speedo and shit. Look like this dude should be in a cheetah print Speedo. Like sprawled out on a fur bed, you know, with his leg all spread apart and stuff like that, like with a shotgun and cats laying around him or something like that. It was just this way this guy looked. I was like, wow, dude. But then he was talking, he's all, hi, how are you today? And you're like, oh shit, dude. No, I can't get around it, man. It's like, goddamn, dude.
It's funny, yeah.
If you're not from here, it cracks you up.
Right.
There's no way around it. It cracks you up. It's kind of like if you go to up to New England or something like that, and somebody has a real hardcore New England, hey, how are you there, you know, like, it throws you off. Yeah, it's like, hey, what's up? So, hilarity.
Yeah.
So.
Yosemite's also been a big help for me the past few days since we left home. You know, I was talking about having a big old blowout with my ex stepkid, whatever. You know, I went on kind of a tear in a video. You know, just cussing him and his mom upside down, my ex, you know, about my daughter. I've been venting, getting over it.
Purging.
Yeah. Letting go, you know. I've had to sit here and defend myself for years to the very people that used to call me their rock, that they depended on me so much, and now I'm such a piece of garbage to them because she and I broke up. Been purging and getting rid of all that garbage. It's, I think, it's stuff I held on to for way too long. When you feel personally attacked over the years and put down so often that, you know, that even now my daughter is believing it, you know, because that's her scope of influence is mainly there. So, but she's 13, she's impressionable, you know, and if she gets fed that shit down her down one ear from one side long enough, you know, you'll start to believe it. So it's kind of a shame, but I went on a tear. She actually got a hold of me and was, which, man, yeah, in one way you're right, you know, she shouldn't be talking to me that way.
Yeah,
she was saying how disappointed in me she was and angry with me she was that I said all those things, and I was like, hey man. But she only knows really one end of it. She's with her mom all the time. And, yeah, what are you going to do?
Yeah.
What are you going to do? So I guess I got to... I guess I got to let go of some shit. Just kind of let it go. I love my daughter. And I don't want to have this back and forth anymore. And, you know, they seem, you know, the impression that the ex and her kid have of me is just like I still owe them something, you know. Even though he left years ago and talked shit and split, and, you know, in 2008, she and I finally broke up for the last time. We reconciled a couple times and tried to keep it together over the years, but it was never going to work. And, you know, when she and I broke up that last time in 2008 over years of emails and texting and stuff of her to other guys, come to find out. So, the hard truth, man. It's a hard truth.
It's a lesson learned.
Lesson learned. Yeah. Like, she always accused me for years of cheating on her and stuff like that, and then come around and I found all those emails all the way back from 2004 to 2008 of her talking to three other dudes. And then there was a fourth dude finally that broke it all up finally. She was, I came home one night after I got off work and she was in there talking to him in the room, talking about how she was going to go see him and have a weekend with him, but she was going to take my daughter, who, she was only 5 at the time, that she was going to take her down to LA because we live in Vegas, you know. This guy was in LA with somebody, her old boyfriend from high school, that they're hooking up online again, and that she was going to go down and see him. I stood out in the hallway and listened to the conversation. It was pretty good, actually. She was all giggling and, oh my God, you know. And I can't wait to see you. And she says, I'll just come down for the weekend. I'll bring my daughter and drop her off at my friend's house. So there's no questions, you know. Like, I'm just going down to see my friends for the weekend and I have my daughter with me. But I'll just drop her off at my friend's and then I'll come and spend the weekend with you. He's all, yeah, all right. I was like, oh. So my daughter was used as a pawn in her little sex game and stuff. And then that's what blew it up between us. I was like, you ain't taking my daughter down there. Fuck that. She's like, oh, you don't tell me what to do. That's my daughter. Blah, 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 blah. I'm like, what the fuck? No, if you want to go get laid, go get laid. You know, fuck it, whatever. But don't use the kids as, you know.
Yeah, they're not pawns. They're not,
yeah,
tools.
Not pawns. They're not your cannon fodder to just use so you can go get some dick, you know. It's the stuff that just, all the accusations that get put
stuff
in me and stuff over the years.
Go.
Yeah, stuff I need to let go of. And, you know, yeah, stuff. You're like, was it that? Was it that thing?
Yeah.
Like, hey.
Hey, hey. Okay.
Just you're going on a rant. Just let it go. Let it go. So, like I said, it's always hard for me to get personally attacked like that over the years when everybody's got shit in their backyard, you know? Clean up your own fucking house first. So, anyway, that's my purge. Fuck them. You know what I mean? Like Kaiser Sose. And it's gone. So, good time. So, from Virginia, touching in, touching base, or touching myself, I guess.
Inappropriately.
on the YouTubins. Man, I'm just gonna get me done, dude. Jesus. All right, we'll check back later.
Yep.
Fun.
Fun.
I bet this will I be. Which will? Will answer. Will. Will. Will out of here.
Oi! What's going on?
Nothing.
I was looking at the back cubby. It's like, we got a lot of junk back there.
Yeah.
Should probably go clean it up. I should probably go eat all that shit so we can get rid of it.
Yeah.
We're in West Virginia. Got loaded this morning. And we fucked up. We didn't take video. The reefer was dead, and I had to jump it. I could have shown how to jump a reefer. You know, it's no big deal. It's kind of like jumping a fucking Daihatsu. But you know, it's got a small. It's got a regular size little 12 volt car battery. Get the reefer motor up there. So stupid me though. I took jumper cables out of the truck a while back for whatever reason and forgot to put them back in and needed jumper cables. Well, you're supposed to have them on you as a requirement for Prime. They give them to you at orientation if you want them, and I thought I had mine, so I didn't buy new ones. So we're at the truck stop earlier and the reefer wouldn't start, and I was like, great, got a hold of the breakdown. Just jump it with the cables. Yeah, so I had to go back into Pilot and buy a new set of jumper cables. $40 later. I'm like, God damn it. Well, at least we got an extra set now.
Yeah.
So, yeah, then you just got the battery posts on the truck. You got to hook up to those, run the cables up to that one, let it go for like 5 minutes, and it started up, and it's like, that's about it. So we're out here on the I-64 Turnpike toll road in West Virginia. That's actually a really nice country.
Yeah, it's pretty.
Yeah, really. West Virginia is actually really nice. It's just everybody makes fun of it. Same as me, you know, about shallow end of the gene pool and all that shit. Nothing is in bloom yet. Although it just snowed, so.
Yeah. It's probably a little bit longer.
Yeah, just probably another couple weeks. Sweet. I've never been on this stretch of road before, so they take easy pass. Happy about that.
Yeah.
Yeah, we just stopped off at the service plaza, switched out, she started driving. At almost, 5 o'clock? My bad. I tried to get some miles under my belt today since it was a slow start. Sorry. Bright. I wonder if it's the brightness of the phone that's making it that way. Because I noticed too in the Nevada video.
Yeah.
What you're saying, it's so bright. It actually came out really bright.
Yeah, if you took the phone sometime. in a different way, it'll like darken up. It's like a little bit.
Oh, there you go. Yeah, so West Virginia. Going to Kentucky next. across to, I think we go all the way across to Louisville, and cross into Indiana, and then Illinois, Missouri, yada, yada, yada. So, good times.
Good motherfucking time, Joe.
I've been sans jokes lately. I don't know why. But
I don't know.
I don't know if that's easy pass, is it?
It's an easy pass only.
Oh, did it?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's got the sensor above it, I imagine it probably is, but this one just says easy pass only. You'd feel like kind of a dill pickle if you pulled up and they go, oh, this is cash only, sir. Are you a sir?
I'm a ma'am. Thank you very much.
Go, excuse me, I'm a he-she.
I'm old.
I've got all equipment. Thank you.
Like you.
What?
What?
Oh, just downing me like my ex and my ex-kid now.
Stop.
I get it. Make them narrow for a reason.
What reason that
yeah, I don't know why, but part of some master plan.
Made some cars.
Yeah. So that's about it.
Yeah.
Another big.
For now.
For now. Wait till something else sensational comes up. So good times. All right. West Virginia.
Who the fuck are you? Who the fuck are you? Who the fuck are you?